Hello YouTube! Welcome to the second part of my low budget roof batten canoe project. Thank you so much for so many feedbacks and comments after the last video. For those who haven't seen my last video, I built a canoe from nothing else than roof battens. The goal was to keep the material cost under 150 Swiss francs or dollars. And I simplified the design that much that it should be possible to craft this canoe within 2 days and with some common tools everyone should have at home. As I was almost finished with my boat, I tested it in the fish pond of my neighbor to see if it's watertight or not. The fish pond is about 5 meters, my boat has 3 meters 70. The test was successful, only a few drops squeezed through such a branch spot. But after painting the boat with boat's varnish, this should be fixed. As I was finished with my canoe, I realized that I'm not really happy with the look, with the design of my canoe. It looks a little bit like a coffin or like a battleship from the World War I. And on top, my neighbor asked me if he can use my canoe as a rice planter box if I don't need my canoe anymore. So that's why I decided to add a slightly raised bow and stern, and like this it should look a little bit more like a traditional Indian canoe. These elements should also serve as handle to carry the boat by hand. I will make it from leftovers I cut it away from the floor. Further on I will attach 10 meter ropes at both ends so that another boat can pull me or that I can tie my boat to a stone or a tree. I have also a special idea for a seat. I really wonder if that works. Later, I want to cut the gymnastic mat that it fit in, so that my knees are padded when I'm pedaling on the knees. How I make a paddle from roof battens, I'll show you in a separate video. So, let's start to work. So, my friends, now I really like the design of this boat. I think it was worth to doing this extra round. And yes, I got hundreds of comments, hints and tips how to increase the driving straight properties, or how to increase the balance that I don't tip, or how to reduce the resistance in the water. But before I think about to change something, I want to make my own experience with exactly this design. Because exactly this design, with a straight floor and a 90 degree sidewall to the floor, is for sure by far the easiest way to craft a canoe with battens. As soon you want to tilt the sidewall, or soon you want to make a radius between floor and wall, it becomes much more complicated. And my goal is to show how to build a canoe who can do everyone who is not totally talent-free in manual work. In a few days, I will meet my friend Taro from the YouTube channel Taro Movies. So he's an experienced canoeist, and we planned a canoe trip about 16 kilometers. So we start right in the front of my house in Little River, and we hopefully end in a little harbor in the Lake of Constance. So after the first test in the fish pond, we choose the hard way. And I can tell you, I'm really nervous. So if you want to know if we were successful or not, please check the video next Friday. So thanks a lot for watching and stay healthy. Cheers.